Hi, I'm Bianca, and today we'll go foraging!
Hi! How are you?
Hi, nice to meet you!
Yeah, so, nice to meet you, yeah.
Hi everyone! Welcome to Gastronomes Home Recipes. Today we are with Isaac, he's from Colombia, and he cooked for us something that requires us to go foraging. What are you going to cook for us, Isaac?
I am going to make Ajiaco. It's a soup that's made with potatoes. It's for cold weather. Bogotá is a cold place. And we normally make it with a herb called Guascas. It's native to the Andes, but another Colombian person told me that you can find it around Pollenzo. So we're gonna look for it.
Pollenzo is so international. So yeah, let's go foraging. We have the right outfit, as you can see.
Yeah, so, like, totally.
Perfectly foraging outfit. Elegance first, guys.
Yeah, like people from Bogotá and Colombia are known for being overdressed and uptight. So I'm here to represent the stereotype. You want some?
Yes.
And like, you can make any kind of, like, the potato soup is not that special, to be honest. It's very special to me, but without this herb, it doesn't taste like ajiaco. Like, without guascas, there's no ajiaco. It's just another potato soup.
Okay, let's collect some.
So let's collect a few of it, but...
Yeah, one of the rules of foraging is to not take too much.
Only take what you need. Yeah, but then you need to look for the plants that have a lot of leaves, because otherwise you're just taking stems, and that's no good.
So let's go to make it.
Yes.
So we're back from our morning of foraging around Pollenzo and Bra in the woods. And now we're ready to start to make the soup. Right?
Yes.
Where are the greens?
It's ready. Well, we have here some potatoes, small ones and big ones, just to have some variety of texture. Also some onions. It's very usual. And you just start by making a very basic chicken soup.
Fresh herbs collected this morning. Great. So, how is it called?
Guascas.
Guascas. Potatoes, onions, right?
And chicken. Yeah, the chicken is in the kitchen, but it's in the fridge, so.
Okay. From where we start first?
Okay, no, we just have to fill out the pots with water and put the chicken in one of them, because we're going to be making no regular one and vegetarian kind. You normally use, my grandmother uses chicken breast, but I like the flavor of chicken legs more, so.
Okay. So this is a recipe that your grandma taught, right?
Yes. She makes it when there's a lot of people coming, normally around the holidays, but not necessarily. And it's also something that you find pretty much everywhere. It's pretty easy to make, it's pretty cheap, and it's always good to have when it's cold outside, which is...
So we have the onions.
Yes, we have the onions, we have the chicken in water, and we're gonna put them together.
Should I turn it on?
Yeah, but I'm just gonna put the onions. Let's put some of the onions in the around the chicken. And on the other hand, we're going to be making the vegetarian one, which is not traditional, but I had a lot of vegetarian friends here in Pollenzo, so I wanted to also share it with them. So I made some vegetable stock in advance.
Mm-hmm. This is so magic.
There we go.
This is a Christmas spirit.
Thank you very much. I'll wear it with honor. So the most labor intensive part is to peel the potatoes and chop them in different shapes.
Okay.
According to the kind of potato, and then, like, taking away the flowers from these and cleaning them up a little bit.
How we cut the potatoes?
Okay, so the more starchy ones, these ones are the red ones. These are the ones who have to go first. So we wash them, we peel them, and we chop them in big chunks.
Okay.
And the yellow ones, we have small yellow ones, which are the ones I think I'm gonna be using for thickening the soup.
Okay.
And so these ones go last. And then we have the big ones, which we're gonna do pretty much the same as we're going to do to the red ones. In Colombia, we have plenty of types of potatoes. It's one of them is very big starchy potatoes that's called papa pastusa. The second one is papa sabanera, which is from the center of Colombia. So papa pastusa is from the south of Colombia, papa sabanera is from the center of Colombia, and papa criolla is like this very different kind of potato that's like yellow. But I think this soup represents the strongest connection I have to the land I'm from. So yeah, it's made with everything that you find around in Bogota, and you only find it in Bogota. So it's like a very marked thing that we find in our city. It's like a very cachaco thing. Cachaco is like what other people from is what people from other parts of the country call
hot potatoes.
Yeah, it's what other people from other regions call people from Bogota. So it's a very cachaco thing. It's like a very thing that it's hot soup from the coldest, from one of the colder places, and it's a place that's famous for being cold. So just potatoes and soup, it's kind of like a match made in heaven.
Of who reminds you this dish?
Of my grandma. Yeah, I mean, last time I was in Colombia before the pandemic, we made this dish together, and it was so much fun, you know, like she doesn't let anyone else go into the kitchen except for people who are gonna help her. So it was like the time for us to spend some time together and to, like gossip a little bit. We love talking about what's going on in the family life. Then chopped into tiny pieces. And we wish you a Merry Christmas. I mean, I can teach you some Colombian villancicos, which is like...
Oh, yes, go.
Okay, so here's gold, yeah, this one that's called Campana sobre Campana.
Campana sobre Campana.
Yeah. Campana sobre Campana, y sobre Campana una, asómate a la ventana, verás al niño en la cuna, Belén. Campanas de Belén, que los ángeles tocan, que bellas me traes. Belén, campanas de Belén, que los ángeles tocan, que bellas me traes. There's a very good friend of mine from the Magistrale. His name is Gibson. He's from Ghana. And one time he invited us all to his place to have Ghanaian food. And it was just, it was my first time eating West African food. It was so, so good. It was completely different flavors than I was used to. It was very interesting finding out that we have so much in common, both South America and Africa, in terms of ingredients, but we make them in completely different ways. For example, we normally eat yuca, and we either boil it or we fry it, and they use yuca, which is kind of the same yuca, and they make something that's called fufu, which is like this cooked paste of yuca. It's so bouncy and it's so good. It was so surprising to see, like, oh yeah, this is yuca. Like, I recognize the flavor, I recognize the texture, but it's a completely different preparation of the same thing I've eaten for most of my life.
It worked.
There you go.
And then you're going to throw them here in the stock.
Yes.
Like, they are the first that goes in the stock.
Yeah. And these ones we're going to cook separately, and we're going to blend them together so that they get become like some kind of potato puree, but very watery potato. So now it's time for the second potatoes, very thinly sliced so that they break up easier. So you can tell there's quite a lot of them. So this is gonna help them get... It is doing pretty well, I think. I think this one's almost ready to get blended. I think so. There we go. And now adding the guascas. Now it is an ajiaco. Before it was just some potato soup. And they're gonna stop being green. They're gonna turn a little bit darker now once they're cooked. The very, 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 very overcooked potatoes. And now I'm gonna try to mash them. Potato puree, it's kind of gooey because the starches, like, they were cooked.
Cheers! Christmas cheers! So you take the chicken, if you're not vegetarian. You put it a bit here.
Yeah, you put like some shredded chicken. Like this one is big chunks, but no problem. There, that's a good looking chunk.
I don't know. And then you put cream.
Yeah.
And then some green...
capers. Not so many, but insert dramatic music. You haven't even tried it yet, Bianca.
Hmm. Oh my god, this is the taste of the plant.
Yeah, of the sriracha. Yeah, you're tasting sriracha with.
I love
some
sriracha.
Other stuff.
Come on, I haven't. Look, I put just a little bit on the meat. You said it. You gave me the freedom to eat.
Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, prospero año y felicidad.
So, thank you, everyone. I don't remember it. Cut. So, we're at the end. So, thank you, Isaac, very much for sharing with us
my
your story.
Pleasure.
And your food, incredible soup. And thank you all for joining us for this special episode. And see you next time for a new one. And guys,
Feliz Navidad.
Happy Holidays.
Feliz Natal.
Felice Weihnachten.
Crăciun fericit, buone vacanze, buon Natale, and see you for the next one. And stay gastronome!